Hey guys, welcome back. I am Suvan Srivastav and today we are going to learn about the ViewSet class and rank Django REST framework. So in the previous videos, we have seen how to create the model make sense in REST framework. And today we will going to create the ViewSet in which we need to write just a few lines of code for creating our view, for creating our CRUD. Okay, so let me remove the whole code from here. And we are going to create a ViewSet instead. Now for creating the ViewSet, we are going to create a new file here and let's name this file as ViewSet.py. So this is our new file. So in this, we need to import our ViewSet. So for importing it, we are going to write from Django. So from REST framework, import ViewSet. And after creating, after importing the ViewSet, we need to create a class for ViewSet. So let's say we want a CRUD on our student database record. So for it, we need to create a class which is student ViewSet. So here we need to inherit ViewSet.modelViewSet from the ViewSet. Now we can specify here the query set and serializer class. So query set is what? So we want to return all the student which are in our database. So student.objects.all. So this will be our query set and we need to import this student. So from student API, import student.models. Import student. Now after specifying the query set, we can specify here the serializer class. So we have our serializer class, this serializer.py, in this serializer.py, which is student serializer. So we need to specify this in our view set. So here we will first import it. So from student API dot serializers, import student serializer. So now our serializer, we have imported our serializer class. So here we can specify it, so student serializer. Now with these three lines of code, we have created our complete CRUD. So now we have to include this student view set in our URL. So for it, we will first go in our urls.py and here we will import. So from ViewSet, import student ViewSet. So we have imported our student ViewSet. Now we need to import one more thing here. So from REST framework, we are going to use routers for creating our ViewSet. So import default router. So after importing the default router, you have to create the router variable here. So router default router. Now our default router is ready, and since our default router is ready, so we can specify in the router, and this router we will register our view set. So router dot register, and here we will specify the URL student API, and after specifying this URL, we need to import ViewSet. So ViewSet import student ViewSet. After importing the student ViewSet, we can write here student ViewSet and the base name of it. So let's say student API. Now we have registered our router. Now this router we need to include in our URL patterns. So here we will specify the path. So and if the path is none, then we will going to include router.urls. And here we will remove these which we have imported from views. So since we have removed them from views, so we are going to remove that from here also. So after removing them, we have to provide the dot here so that it will understand that it is our file, and we will remove this from here. And now let's check if our API is working correctly or not. So for it, I need to we will go to our URL. So here you can see our API is ready with just two lines of code. We have just specified the query set and the serializer class here. In the query set, we have given all the student that is in our database and the serializer class we have provided. And with these two lines, we have created the complete CRUD on our website. So let's see. So you can see here all the list of student has been shown here, and you can insert more student from this field HTML form, or you can provide the data in the form of JSON also. So if you will type a specific ID of student, so your router will going to handle it. So for example, I am giving 11. So you can see the student with ID 11 is shown here. So we can even delete this and update using this put request. So anyone who is making request can access our API. So we have some other classes also available in the view set, for example the authentication classes. So in the authentication classes, we can specify here. So first we need to import the authentication class from REST framework dot authentication import basic authentication, and we can specify here the basic authentication. So when we do this, so only the user which have username or password can access our API. Or when someone will make the request for GET, he has to provide username and password with that data. So only then he can access our API. So, or we can have a here permission classes, and in the permission classes, so we can specify here that if user is authenticated, only then we are going to give access to our API to that user. So here we can specify, so from REST framework dot permissions import is authenticated. So here in the permission class, we can specify that user should be authenticated. So now let's see if our API is working correctly or not. So when we will go for accessing our API and type this URL, okay, so I need to restart the server. Now it is asking us for providing the username and password. So here, let me provide the username and password. Okay, so I haven't remembered what was the password. So let me create a user first. So here you will specify the username and password. So in the username field, I'm specifying the username, and here I will write the password. And when you will sign in, okay, so I have written the wrong password, so I need to write it again. Now let's see. And as you can see, when we have provided the username and password, only then we are accessing our API. So in this way, we have other permissions also. So in this, you can specify that admin can only access the API. So here we need to import it first from here. So is admin user, and here we will specify is admin user. Now after doing so, only the admin user will access our API. Since I have logged in with the credentials of admin. That's why I am able to access my API. So this is all about view sets in our Django REST framework. So in this way, you can specify other classes or serializers or models here for creating the CRUD with just few lines of code using the view set. So this is all for today. Thank you for watching.